Well, welcome back to the plan development workflow video series for FDoc Connect. In this video, I will go over the signature sheet, which covers chapter 2. All projects must be signed and sealed by the engineer of record. Therefore, each project requires a signature sheet. This chapter will show the tools used to correctly create a signature cell and sheet. For more information about signature sheets and their requirements, see Part 3, Chapter 303 of the FDM. So the topics we're going to cover in this video will be creating custom signature cells from the provided seals.cell library within the FDoc Connect software. And then from there, we will create our signature sheet. So let's get started. So the first thing we'll need to do is we'll need to make a copy of the provided seals.cell library. So what you'll want to do is you'll want to launch your Windows Explorer, and we will navigate to our FDoc Connect install. On mine, it's a workstation install, so it's located locally on C drive. So on C, we'll go into FDoc Connect, Organization Civil, FDoc, in my cell folder. So I'll scroll down here towards the bottom and locate my seals.cell. And then what I want to do is I want to just right click and copy. So from here, I'll browse back to my worksets location. So let me just jump back to C and worksets, my FDOT folder, and then my project folder. And for this one, I'll actually drop it in my cell folder. So I'll just do a right click and paste. And just a note for anybody watching that, like CAD managers or something, what you can do is you can actually copy this provided cell library and place it back into the workspace. So let me come back to FDoc Connect, and we've got a workspaces folder set up. So let me launch in there, and I'll go to FDoc, and then in there you want to go to standards. And in this cell folder, if you drop it in here, you can place it in there, and then it can be accessed by any of your users through the cell library dialog. So, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use the one local for my project. So let me back up to that one, and then I'll actually just rename this. So I'll name it SR61 and underscore seals. So now that I've got that created, let me go ahead and open that in my FDoc Connect software. So I'll launch FDoc Connect for OpenRoads. So now I'll do a browse, and I'll browse up to my cell folder. And you may need to switch your file type again. Just do all files just to make it easy. And then I'll grab my seals and then just open that up. And you may get a note saying that that particular library is not associated with your workset, and that's fine. What you want to do is just use your active workspace and workset. So we'll just open that up. And so once we first launch it, I'll just do a fit view here. There are some instructions on how to use this library. And basically, it's just because of the way MicroStation handles text along alignments. You'll just need to go through and make sure you follow these steps. Otherwise, we have seen issues where some of the text will come in straight rather than wrapped around like we have it set with these seals. So just make sure you follow these steps whenever you're copying and creating your seals. So what we'll want to do is let me open up my models dialog. And we want to make a copy of our professional engineer seal. So I'll just grab that one, do a right click and copy. And then what we'll do is we'll give it a name. So for this, I would typically name it dependent upon, of course, your engineer. So for this one, I'm just going to do my name. I'm also just going to add the PE seal so I know what type of seal it is. So we'll do OK. And now I can go ahead and close my models dialog. And I'll just do a fit view. So next, what I want to do is I want to switch to my drawing production tab. And we'll grab our edit text tool. And so we'll change our signature name text right here. And just go ahead and change that to, again, I'm going to put my name. And then we'll left click to accept. And then we'll also need to make sure we add the appropriate license number as well. So I'll do that one in there. And so that's all we need to do to create our custom seal cells. So from there, what we can do is I'll just close out of the library. So do a file close. And then you may see this dialog pop up just saying it's been disassociated, and that's fine. So then from here, let me jump back into my blank file. And next, we'll actually create our signature sheet file. And once I'm back in the file, let me just switch to fdot and grab my create file tool. So again, just make sure the discipline is set to roadway file group, roadway sheet files. And this time we want to find our sign RD. So here it is down towards the bottom, signature sheet. And so this one, when it creates it, it's going to go ahead and give us our sheet model for our signature sheet. So again, make sure the county is Wakulla for this project. Do create open. And then we'll just close. So now if you'll notice, once we're in our signature sheet, what that action did was it created our sheet model for us. And it's already placed our sheet border for us as well. So now that we're in the file, what we want to do is we want to switch to our drawing tab. And in the placement group, we'll just come and select our place active cell tool. So from here, I want to just browse out and I'll find my cell library. So I'll just do a file and I'll do an attached file and I'll go find my cell library. But just another side note, if you did create your custom cell library and you placed it back into the FDOT Connect workspace in that standards folder, you'll see those populate down here at the very bottom. So that's how we've got that set up. So just kind of easy access for any standards that you may have set. So for mine, I'll just come back up to attach file and I'll go browse to my cell library for my project. So C drive, work sets, FDOT, project cell, and here's my SR61. So I'm just going to open that up. And then I want to place my Thorpe PE cell. So I'll just double click on that one and it makes it my active cell. So let me just move this out of the way. And then I'll just kind of zoom in and place this in the top left corner there. So, and then I'll just right click to get out of that tool. And I can go ahead and close my cell library dialog. So next, what we'll need to do is we'll need to place our signature information. And that is done using our Link Data Manager tool. So let me switch back to the FDOT tab. And I'll launch my LDM again. So, and we will do a create link. And this one is going to be create from template again. So this time we want to make sure we switch our type to Word documents. And then we want to select our statement for responsibility for signature sheet. And we want to grab our professional engineer. So I'll click OK. Again, it's going to ask me where I want to save this file. And I'll just place this one in my roadway folder again. So click save. And so we also want to make sure that we toggle off the page boundary right here. Because if we leave this on, what it's going to do is it's going to give us a little boundary around this piece of text, and we don't want that. So I'll just turn that off. And then I'll click OK. And it's attached that little bit of text to my cursor again. So what we want to do is we want to place this down below our seal. So I'll just left click to place that in there. And we shouldn't have to change anything with the text here. But if you did, again, what you would do is just come into your LDM, do your open source, edit it there, save your Word document, come back into LDM, and then just update it. So now that we've got the statement of responsibility note attached, what we'll need to do is place our signature information. So what we'll need to do is we'll need to go back to our Windows Explorer and browse to our WorkSets F.Project and Roadway folder. And what we want to do is we want to copy our component index. And we'll paste that in here, and we're going to rename it Sheets Responsible For. So this is going to be a list of all the sheets that this EOR is responsible for. All right, so now that we've done that, we'll come back into OpenRoads. And on our LDM, we'll create a new link. And this time we're going to create it from a file. So we'll do our select existing file. And we're going to select that Excel file that we just copied. So we'll open that. And so for Excel files, we get a few Excel settings in here. What we want to do is we want to make sure we select our worksheet. So for this one, we want sheet 1. And then we'll just click OK. And so in here, we're just going to place that below that statement of responsibility. And then what we will do is we'll come back over to LDM. And we'll just go ahead and open up this Excel file. So it's just kind of giving us a blank starter file, essentially, with our key sheet and then just the typical sections in there. So the first thing we want to do is we want to add our header in here. And so what we're going to do, this is going to be our roadway plans. Actually, let me bring that one over to A. So, and then what we'll do is we'll just fill this out based on the training guide. We're on page 2-11 if you're following along in the guide. So we'll do 2 is going to be so, and this is just an example of some of the sheets that were included in this particular dataset project. You may or may not have all of these. You may have more than what's listed here on your project as well. So once we've got that filled out, I'll just do a save and close Excel. So now what I'll need to do is I'll need to come in here and update, and then it'll run through and it's updated from that Excel sheet. So as you go along, you can just update that Excel sheet, but then you'll need to make sure you come back into this file and just run an update on here as well so that it picks those up. So now the next part is going to be placing the signature information. And the digital signature appearance info is placed using LDM as well. So while we're still using have Link Data Manager open, what we'll do is we'll create a new link, and we're going to create one from template again. And so we want to make sure we switch to our Word documents. And this one is going to be our required text for digital appearance signature on signature sheets. So we'll click OK. And again, we'll save that one into our Roadway folder. And again, just make sure we uncheck this page boundary right here. So once I've got that set, I'll click OK. And again, it's attached it to my cursor. So what we'll do is we'll just come up next to our seal and we'll just place that information right there. And then again with LDM, what we want to do is we want to actually open up that source. So our digital signature appearance. So let me open source and we'll go modify the generic information in here. So for company name, I'm just going to fill this out based upon what's in the guide. And with these LDM documents, it's important to note not to change any text size or formatting or anything like that. Otherwise, it can mess it up once you go back into your design file. And then I'll just make sure and save that. Close, come back in here, and once again, just do an update. And so if you have multiple engineers on one project, what you would do is just that exact same process throughout the rest of the sheet. You should be able to get, looks like maybe six or so engineers on here. So that covers chapter two of our plans development guide for F.Connect. All right. And so once again, thank you for joining me. This went over chapter two of the signature sheet. The next video in this series, we'll go over chapter three, which is going to cover typical sections.